both sides of that and still get the healing at range safely from Fielder.
So, as we expected, both teams play the Winston D.Va. Tracer's still a factor here. And here's the dive. They're trying to catch Nosemite up against that wall, but he just leaps off to safety. Comfortably, Fielder sits back in that corner. FD God got pressured down briefly by a hack, but he'll be healed. And this is just pleasantries right now. A couple blows being traded by nothing, but nothing lethal.
Yeah, well, I mean, the Paris Eternal, the longer the fights go on, like I was mentioning, and then you have Kanemniko, like, poke down with the Echo at range, the better. These are when the fights are not good for the Paris Eternal, when you can get a hack and then get aggressive. This is where the Gladiators come, definitely outshines Paris.
I mean, there's still a big window where Fielder is unable to keep Nosemite alive. OG just walked up, slammed the shield down, put him in a snow globe, and then there was nothing that Fielder could do. He just had to look on outside, and in that,
well,
you know,
I mean, if you're
second
gonna play,
or so, it was too late.
Yeah, and if you're going to fall back to that position immediately without challenging the choke, you could have probably just played the Moira. Like, you didn't really kind of get the benefits of Yana in that type of situation.
Yeah, Moira can at least sort of follow Winston in or rush to his side quickly with bait if required, but we will see the Eternal switch. Well, actually, no, they won't switch up the Yana. Maybe they've fancied the Nano Boost here for no smite, help him build another Primal Rage.
You're so close to it, you don't switch off of it now.
Yeah.
You give it a fight.
Nico from above. Okay, there goes the Nano Winston there, but Nico got blown up. Coalescent Shaz, beautiful tracking for that man. Pulse Bomb thrown down. Bird Ring gets himself the Sound Barrier here, and the Gladiators are on that snowball ting mat. They're looking to try and finish this off. OG was put to
poor
sleep.
Poor OG, dude.
That's a rude awakening. I guess he never woke up in that regard. It's kind of sad. Either way, still no smite with a Primal Rage, trying to get some work done with it, but he can't find a target that's low enough to finish off when the Eternal are running out of defensive options, Matt.
But they're going to be able to get a hold, because you lose OG, who's about to have Primal, which is a big loss for the Gladiators. Now you lose Mirror towards the end, so the Paris Eternal will get a hold here, and they won't even give up a tick to the Gladiators. So for what it's worth, a good defense here for Paris. It didn't look like it was going to be good at the start, but they're able to turn it at the end. So Paris, so to do it, Mitch, they have to use pretty much all their ultimates. So we'll see the LA Gladiators come back with a window of opportunity here. Pulse Bomb, Primal Rage, Self-Destruct. You'll probably end up with a Coalescence here to use as well. So this could be the Gladiators setting a very fast time.
Space is averaging 40 seconds per ultimate right now on that D.Va. So he is very involved in a lot of these fights and is out damaging the rest of his team for the time being. See the man himself just perch up on the high ground. What's there to be seen? Okay, nice job. He gets no smite low and harmed in the source of low. There's no sound barrier to save these two main tanks right now. This is dangerous for Paris. Somehow they get no smite up the hill. Fielder has to get in there though. Now there's going to be a nano boost once more to no smite. He needs to do something with this. Get a quick primal rage and make the fight go longer. Give FD God time to build up his sound barrier. That'll be hard now though, as no smite got hacked and couldn't do damage, let alone get ultimate charge. And again, the Gladiators start well. Sound barrier from FD God had to be used just to buy a little bit more time for Paris, but it's unlikely to be enough at this stage. OG sleeping on the job, but he's already got two ticks on the point for the rest of his team. And the Eternal have one more chance, Matt, to try and turn this around.
Yeah, Nico's going to come back and have a duplicate, so you're going to have double Winston on the point for the Paris Eternal, potentially with the double Primal, as Nico's going to pop his Primal Rage. No smite his as well.
Oh, that's uncouth from the Paris Eternal. Two Winstons, two Primals, and not a speck of Gladiators left. The Janitor's got in there real quick. And that is possibly one of the more, how do I put this, oppressive things that you can do with Echo. Like, and the Eternal were down three players in that fight.
It's like a button that just wipes away the rules of hero limits and just lets you do stuff you're not meant to do anymore. But that'll be the double Primal, which ends up saving the Paris Eternal in the end. It's that Nico's able to pick up two kills with this.
Space low. Okay, this is a bit of a non-starter right now for the Gladiators. Losing that mech so early, and Nosemite will chase some kills down. So the Eternal have some time now to ponder their present position, which is, I mean, fairly good. Voskaya Industries, yeah, you lose the first round quite early, or the first point, but you got a big turnaround. You take a lot of wind out of the Gladiator's sails and give yourselves time to build these ultimates. Fielder still hasn't switched off his Ana.
Well, no, because they haven't really done a nice job of diving him. He's been able to play so far back that they haven't been able to access him, the Gladiators. So you've been getting a lot of nice biotic grenades, good uses of the nano boost. So why switch? And well, he switches now. As he had no ultimate, they had just used the nano in the last fight. So maybe he just wants a consistent healing of the Moira for the end.
Hanmin goes for the bomb. No Smite gets a little bit of protection from that, but here's the EMP. It's on the three. Hanbin has to step up now as someone who wasn't hacked, but he got manually done in by Mirror later. Again, the Eternal start off the fight being three players down. Nico can return to the fray and might be able to couple a Primal. Mitchell, it won't be two at once. It'll be one after another.
I'm going to say it, though. He's going to come back, and you're going to have this other Primal, which could be a difference maker. As the Gladiators, they back out. They just get everybody healed up at full strength. Double D.Va coming in here for the Paris Eternal.
That's a lot of health points there. Nico, if he gets to remech as well, that's even more extra health for him. He won't be spending much time, only about 4 seconds inside that D.Va form, but again, it's just health. He's just throwing health points at the Gladiators, daring them to try and cut through them. They do, but it takes too long.
It's so difficult to break through having that third tank jump on in as the Gladiator is getting very close, but it's taken them so much time because of the duplicates.
Yeah, Birdering now has to step above and beyond the Call of Duty, as opposed to what he was normally doing. Getting rid of an extra tank in every fight is no mean feat for a Tracer, especially with all the armor you have to deal with. Empty God now is the lone man standing, and that will be a capture for the Gladiators, but it occurs with only 53 seconds left, and the stall potential of Echo honestly reminds me of the way the players used to exploit, you know, having five D.Vas to stall a point.
Yeah, they just kind of rotated out.
You know, you add 300 health points in many cases, sometimes 800 if you get to resuit after going for an early self-destruct as D.Va. That, against Tracer Sombra compositions, is not easy to work through. These comps are not really designed to cut through durable targets. They go for squishies.
Especially not that type of situation where Paris Eternal Hanbin had a self-destruct and then you had Nico switch to a duplicated D.Va and use a self-destruct as well. So now, like, we know how much time self-destruct takes to, like, clear out a point and reset and whatnot. Having one after another, then another player coming back and another player coming back after that, just with that duplicate, you know, that cycle of ultimates, you're able to get back at full strength and fight it. And then you also have more HP at the time because of having that extra tank for the moment. So it's very difficult, especially for a team like the Gladiators, the composition they have, to break through it. The Gladiators, though, they had enough ultimates and just kind of damage and good target selection to be able to pull it out in the end. Probably would have been a much faster time if we weren't in the situation where the Paris Eternal had these duplicates at the moment they had.
Matt, is Echo objectively better in this composition than the Sombra?
I don't think you can say for certain, to be honest. I actually think like Sombra is so powerful in the situations that you can make her work. I think it's just when the fights get drawn out, like that's when Sombra becomes less effective because of just her overall damage output. The damage output of the Echo is a bit higher. But if you can get these hacks and get good, like, target priority, and if you can get that first kill in a fight, especially, and you get the Sombra rolling with some easy free damage, that's where the Sombra can be extremely effective.
Focusing Beam is definitely going to be scolding OG as he scrabbles for safety. But he has to push on outside here. The Paris Eternal have been able to sort of control the room that the Gladiators would otherwise have tried to retreat to, and it's paying off for them now. Fielder gets the Coalesce because the healing is so much easier to get value from those Biotic Orbs when his team have taken position in the bunker. They have taken the Gladiators, I guess, you know, territory away from them, and then they're using it against them. Here's that EMP. It's very, very good, and it's a good combo with the self-destruct. Could have gotten even more, but the rest of the Eternal are able to walk away. Now Paris have to make this late fight look good, but they have a potential second D.Va or Winston in play, and I don't know how the Gladiators cut through this.
Yes, I feel like Space has done so much in this series. Well, I know he gets a self-destruct kill and he eats a pulse bomb, but to be the Gladiators going in using their sound barrier. It'll be Nico and the duplicate using a self-destruct, another self-destruct place in the point. The Gladiators kite around both of them.
Yeah, that was really clever. Nico actually punishes Big Goose for going aggressive, forces him to go to the high ground to avoid the duplicated D.Va bomb, and then he's chased down by No Smite. Love to see it. The Eternal now have a sound barrier on four players. Hanbin needed to resuit. Him failing to do that now might be a problem for the Eternal. They're going to lack some staying power if Fielder can't stay alive, but he does. He keeps No Smite topped up, and again, the Eternal go once more. It's ripples as Paris once again to commit to a fight, and getting rid of OG with a pulse bomb is very high value here. No Smite backs away quickly. Mirror tries to build up another EMP, but the Eternal are actually taking their time. A brief reprieve, a disengage, and now they push back in. No Smite on top of Space, and again, the Gladiators retreat to the bunker on the low ground. The Eternal have the real estate now, and they're selling for a profit. One tick for them on the point. Birdring trying to harass from the high ground, but gets chunked down early. Shaz and Big Goose are missing, and now the healing's gone for the Gladiators. Somebody get these guys!
by the Doctor. There's nobody home, and the Paris Eternal are going to have this point taken up now. A clever disengage, and then the push comes in.
Yeah, as OG switches over to the Wrecking Ball just to try and get back, get a touch extended even further, but he'll go back to play Winston. It's the Gladiator still. This is where I think Sombra can be a little bit more effective as well. Like, she's always been good at Valskaya point B, right? Being able to control the health packs, easy areas to EMP, really, with only one main choke to go through.
No smite straight on in. No messing with this guy. Oh, Mira! Couldn't get away. He had EMP available. That would have been the backstop the Gladiators were looking for. And now they don't really have much to lean back on. Again, the Paris Eternal look like they're going to do what they've done all series long. Solid defense and a voracious attack. Over the top is Big Goose trying to get to the fight, but this has gotten out of hand way quicker than the Gladiators would have liked. Mirror's EMP gets completely stifled, and the lights stay on for now. Big Goose also missing his trouble here for Space, who can't get away after he commits an OG on the signature Wrecking Ball, but even the belly is not going to be enough to keep him standing here. Fielder for two, and there is FD God finishing off Shaz. The supports take center stage, and the Eternal take it in 3 minutes and 35 seconds, and they are way ahead in time bank.
And I'm not exactly sure if that was intentional or planned or they knew where. But No Smite jumps right up to the high ground, and somebody forces Mirror to translocate over on the lower side by the point, and he actually translocates like right into No Smite. And as soon as they get that kill on the Sombra, especially when she has EMP, I mean, that's what you're playing around if you're the Gladiators, right? To lose that at the beginning of the fight, where you'd rather have the EMP at the beginning when you're full strength, that's where things fall apart. And I don't know if you can kind of pin it on Mirror. I think it may just be a little bit of an unlucky circumstance where he translocated and just happened to be on top of the tank who was kind of roaming around the back.
Sure.
For Paris, but what a poor time to have something so unfortunate not go your way. It ends up going the way of Paris, right? I mean, they love it.
The Gladiators, well, they weren't ready for that at all. Mirror without a translocator up on that high ground, it kind of indicates to you that the Gladiators were not expecting the Eternal to be so brisk in pressuring towards point B, and what a way to win! Take the enemy team by surprise and follow up with excellent execution. Now the Eternal, they have 2.5 minutes lead on the Gladiators here, and let's see if their defense can hold up to the test. The Gladiators now once more, as they have all season long, struggling when it comes to time bank scenarios.
And this has to be good for the Gladiators, especially this early fight, because of the way that you're, I mean, you're playing with the Sombra. You're not gonna generate, you know, charge towards EMP quickly, whether it be through hacks and then eliminations after that. You're gonna be in a very difficult spot as Big Goose gets hit with some sticky grenades, has to back up a bit.
Yeah, it'll be fine. They'll need to take a moment, and that moment was enough of a window for Nico to finish Bird Ring off. And yep, well, you asked for it. Eternal now want to build some extra ult percentage because there's only one fight left. If they can get things like Coalescence available quicker, they'd be very happy. But that's unlikely to happen now, as the Gladiators have taken way more damage.
And if you're Paris, you don't mind pushing the issue because of the time bank that you've set for point B. Even if you lost this first point, you're still in an advantageous position.
So here's the early Coalescence. Let's see how much of a difference it makes. Harbin goes low, and Shaz would have loved to have finished off the D.Va mech, but he has to keep his front line alive. Nico wraps around, Big Goose went to go to the point, and that is going to be overtime, but the Gladiators are nowhere near touching, and the second Coalescence look better. Fielder is able to work Bird Ring down, and the Eternal now set themselves up for a series victory. They're going to have 3.5 minutes left to get one tick on point A, and you've got to be pleased with that. The Eternal looks so good in this meta.
Yeah, they've looked ever since map one, they have looked very good. I think it probably has to do around with obviously the maps, the differential in the maps. Like, think about how much more impactful like Sombra is on a game mode like Control, right? Where the point is very structured and they have to play close together, and they were able to win some early fights where the Echo wasn't having like the biggest impact. Since they've had to, they haven't had to switch off of the Sombra, but since we've gotten to some maps and game modes where it's a little bit less impactful in certain areas, that's where Paris has been able to really unlock the potential of their composition.
The Gladiators now look down the barrel of a difficult sort of mid-month campaign here, trying to make their way into this May tournament. This is one of the matches that you, from their perspective, you probably don't count on losing. You probably feel more confident now, but the Eternal,
their twist, or at least their take on this current hero pool, adds so much with this Echo.
I will say, though, like, the both of these teams are extremely strong. Like, even if the Gladiators lose here to the Paris Eternal, it doesn't really change, at least my opinion, of the Gladiators overall as a team. I still think they're extremely strong.
Sure.
And their next game they would have is next week, I believe, against Boston. So they do have a game coming up that they can get right back on track.
Well, for now, we're going to try and stay in this series. The Eternal again, trying to catch them off guard. Push in. A lot of confidence in one another there, but soon maybe too much of it there. He got hacked and there was no way of recalling. With him out of the fight, yeah, going to be a quick little regroup.
So you have to back up here if you're Paris. You don't want to go in without your Tracer. So that time Mirror did a nice job of just kind of locating soon, getting a hack off, getting that advantage. It's going to be another hack that actually didn't go off. It got interrupted. So now the Gladiator is going to have to give up some space.
Yeah, very small cooldown for Mirror on that one. He'll be looking for another target, though, post-haste. No Smarties down here, so Fielder really getting stretched to the limit, trying to keep his team up, but Shaz gets an earlier coalescence. Fielder will hold this, though, and the Eternal are trying to establish a situation where they have both of their support ultimates coming into the next fight, plus a duplicate. So think about the effective health that provides you. The healing from those support ultimates is effective health, plus Nico getting an extra between 3 and 800 health,
yes,
depending on who he copies.
It's just playing a heavy sustain comp, right, with your Moira as well. That'll be an EMP. They don't connect with Nico. But I think now, if you're the Paris Eternal, you probably just cut your losses and back up.
Yeah.
The Gladiators, they end up using EMP. They use Pulse Bomb here. I think you just kind of lose this fight. Trade a coalescence for an EMP and a pulse bomb, and now if you're the Paris Eternal, you have everything you want to work with.
Matt soon keeps getting hacked as soon as he tries to go in there. That's the perfect focus here from the Gladiators to remove arguably the most dangerous threat, the ever
absolutely
aggressive soon.
Because he's going in and trying to finish off some of these players that Nico and the rest of his team are damaging from afar.
Soon's playing at a more respectable distance now, and both teams go for the sound barrier. That's the D.Va duplicate by Nico. Fielder has to fade away. He's low, and he's going to get chased. The Gladiators try and push up, but Shazzy bites off more than he can chew. Fortunately, Big Goose and Birdring are there to pick it up. And Nico heads to the high ground. His duplicate didn't really yield him too much, and Hanbin just wants his mech back. At this stage, the Paris Eternal, this is starting to get a little bit dicey now. They were hoping for a smoother push, but they managed to force a Primal Rage out of OG here late in the fight that arguably was already lost for Paris. So that is a victory at least that can help sustain them.
Yeah, but you're okay if you're the Gladiator. So, like, you obviously use the Primal at the end, but no, Smite doesn't have his, and you have EMP coming up. So you still feel like you're in a really good spot if you're the Gladiators, where if the Gladiators can get away from this fight with just using, like, EMP, maybe even Pulse Bomb, if you really need to, you're in a great spot. Big EMP, that's going to connect with four players.
Again, Fielder no chance to use his Coalescence even if he would have wanted it to, and the Gladiators now are playing two modes. One is the fight win with EMP, the other is Coalescence. That time they used both, but they are draining the Eternal's resources, and now there's one more fight left. If Mirror can isolate soon early in the fight or hack No Smite and prevent healing from Fielder, this will be over.
But you see how effective now that the Sombra comp is when it starts to get going.
We'll see what Mirror can do. He has to build ultimates quickly. The Gladiators don't have much to work with. Different tact here for the Eternal. They can go to the high ground, make it a bit more dangerous for the Gladiators to play inside. And again, they're going to take this bunker first. Soon needs to find a kill. Maybe a pulse bomb finish could be what he's looking for. Mirror on the low ground. Can't Trent locate away? That's the opening. He's beamed down by Nico, and now it's a 6v5. Soon wants to push in a Fielder, use that coalescence to good effect. The Eternal were at 6. Now they lose one. Fielder's down, and it's going to be a sound barrier for the Gladiators, which is responded to by Paris. They've got Primal Rage. They've got Nico in a D.Va form. They've got Self-Destruct. They've got health for days, and they plan to make use of it here. Self-Destruct on the point. Birdery has to hide behind the pipes for the time being, and that takes away an opportunity for him to work these tanks down. Nico steps up. His duplicate was gainful. Gets the Self-Destruct and now beams in from over the top. The Coalescence interrupt from Shaz. No healing available now from the Gladiators, and that's all she wrote. It'll be a desperate attempt for Mirror, but all he sees in the mirror is his team's demise. The Paris Eternal take the series away, and that signature brand of aggression gets them there.
And yet again, what's the difference at the end? It's having those duplicates. Like, when they work, they get a duplicate again from Nico. He takes D.Va's form there. and he's able to use another self-destruct to clear off the point. The gladiators have to separate. And then when the gladiators come back, guess what happens? Hanbin just drops another self-destruct on the point. They have to separate. Like, you can't heal everybody all through it. Players, both your tanks are split on one side of each of, you know, that central, you know, kind of pillar storage area. And you're just in a lot of trouble in that type of situation because your healing is already so scarce with Moira Lucio in a spread out scenario, and now they spread you out, they've gotten high ground, and they spread you out for a solid, you know, 8 to 10 seconds there. So, very difficult to heal through, very difficult to coordinate. The gladiators tried their best, but Paris comes out on top.
I'm surprised it took Paris maybe as long as it did to